So, top 10 industries which I think are already using blockchain and have many applications in blockchain are as follows. You have banking and payments, all the banking things and all the payments are already using blockchain. Let me use such an example. Insurance inherently has a lot of problems which blockchain is solving. And well into each of these 10 things in detail, I have a slide or two on each of these verticals. Then healthcare, real estate, crowdfunding is going big time with blockchain. Then energy management, charity is again big time going. This order may not be really relevant when it comes after 5, you know, which is bigger, which is small. Then cyber security, supply chain management, and private transport and ride shares also are coming into blockchain. The first 5 are very important. They are already in many companies who are running blockchain based applications, platforms. And the last 5 are places where there is nascent and opportunity for any of the entrepreneurs who want to start and build into. So I have a slide on each of these 10 things. My slides are very bad. Even after being with Nanju for so long, I have not picked up his slide skills. Banking and payment. What are the problems this banking and payment as a vertical, as a domain face today is fraud. There's a lot of fraud. How to reduce fraud? How to do your KYC very quickly? KYC is a big thing nowadays across the globe. So how do you do it quickly? In India, we also have what is called as re-KYC. KYC is not enough, re-KYC is there. So you do KYC every 6 months, every one year, because your names change when you get married, your names change when you have someone, you give some money. So re-KYC, you stay for some more time, you have re-KYC. Smart contracts, there will be lot of smart contracts. India is not yet picked up, but there are lot of other bankings where contracts, it could be just triparty contract, it could be just LC contract, like credit contracts, could be just that I deliver goods to you, you say yes, then you get the money back. So such type of contracts. And payments, how to make payments quicker. If I have to transfer money from here to Singapore, can I do it in 15 minutes? Can I do it in 1 minute? Can I do it in 30 seconds? Payments, Ripple solves that payment problem, and Ripple is still doing that. And of course, trading platform. How can I trade quicker, easier, and the problems associated with trading platforms as of today. So these are the problems, and each one of these companies, like Agra, Atlas, Open Bazaar, many other banks like UBS and Barclays, have already applications and platforms which are solving some of these problems. There are umpteen number of other companies, especially in banking and payment section, which I'll show you the companies at last slide. But
SBI is supposed to be doing
it. Yes. SBI wants to do payments. KYC is a very good example, wherein I claim that I am Satya, and 4 people have to say, yes, I know him, he is Satya. I claim that I am 40 years old and staying here in JP Nagar, and 5 people have to say that, yes, I know. And I cannot. I cannot change that data. After 4 people saying that I know that he is 40 years old, I cannot say, I am getting some SOPs if he is less than 40, so I cannot go back and say I am 38, let me get that SOP. You will not get it because 4 people have already vouched that you are 40 years old, your name is Satya, I know him and he stays in JP Nagar. So all this information has been validated by the chain. So you can't go back and change the chain. So KYC is a very, very good example. Smart contract is a very good example. There are many companies. It is, I would not say saturated, but going towards saturation. First 5 are already moving towards saturation. And insurance. Insurance is the second big thing. Problems associated with insurance, you all know. Lack of trust. You have insurance. I worked in US in a healthcare industry where there was too much of fraud in health insurance itself, wherein the hospital, everyone has insurance and everyone has one annual free checkup which you get through the insurance company, health insurance company. And many people forget to get their annual health check done, the free annual health check done, because if you are fit or you are too busy with your life, you don't get it done. But the tax, but the hospital bills it towards the end of the term. Hospital bills it, saying that Mr. X had come, he had got his annual check done, everything looks fine. And then when they sent those reports, could be blood reports, eye reports, physical reports, from the last year's data, that he was 60 kgs and he was 5.8, he has not grown, whatever, and bill the insurance company that he had got his health checkup done just before the insurance lapses for that particular year. So there is insurance, and talk about agri insurance in our country, it's full of fraud, lack of trust and fraud, especially agri insurance. They would have not even put that crop and they would still go back and claim that I had losses in that crop. Or they would have put that sugar cane example. They would have put 1 acre of sugar cane. They would have had rest of the land barren and would go back and claim that I had lost all the crop due to whatever, drought or over floods or whatever it is. So, and high cost associated with all these checks. So when it what happens with the agri loan, agri insurance? You know, a village accountant will come to your land and you bribe him 200 rupees and he would say that yes, I went, I did a check, and this is the photograph. The whole land is devastated due to rains, flood, and he takes the 200 rupees and gives a report that huge loss. 5 cows died. Could not have photographs for it, but he will say yes, yes. I could even see 5 cows died, and each cow is 10,000 bucks. So he has incurred 50,000 bucks inefficiencies. And many are not insured. The insurance industry itself, many of them are not insured because of all these things. Like of course, high cost. I don't have the wherewithal to pay the premium to get insured. So how can this? How can these things get addressed by blockchain? Lack of trust. If 4 people don't say that he has really lost crop, he has 5 cow deaths, and if other data doesn't support this, then this claim would not go forward. So lack of trust can be taken care of. High cost, if you remove a middleman, if you remove a manual intervention, then the costs come down automatically. When cost comes, when you remove manual process, inefficiencies will come down. And when these two come down, the cost is not inhibitive, then many people get insurance. There are many such companies. There's like this Eternity, the Chaintag, and French Insurance. Frenchurance is one such thing where there is no company. It is, Frenchurance is a friend insurance wherein everyone in the blockchain, everyone in the platform are insured and they are also owners of the company. So it is like a win-win situation for both of them. There is no underwriter, there is no company which deals with it, but there is a platform, there are administrative tasks, the platform cannot run on its own, the banks cannot run on its own. So that is a good example which is getting very popular. So you could improve the claims processing through smart contracts. When someone says, smart contract is when someone says that I have had A, B and C as some entities and 10 people vouch for it. Yes, he had A, B yes, he had B, and yes, he had C, then if the vouching process goes seamlessly through a chain and through a distributed network, then what happens? The claims go out faster and faster. So B3I is basically the construction of so many companies which are dealing with insurance. So
I see. Could put run through and follow questions. You can read as
it is. Yes, absolutely. So these are the inefficiencies and how they have been addressed in insurance. Then healthcare, as you know, healthcare where you have data and you don't want to show your data to everyone. Sharing of data is a very big thing to only authorized persons. So blockchain solves that problem. It also gives you audit trail. You have IoT data. I'll give you a small example. A good idea for entrepreneurs is this is a good idea for the entrepreneurs. Not that much there in India. The doctor says that you have to exercise, and the patient agrees that I will exercise in the second one. And there is a health coin associated. This, if you exercise so much, then I'll give you a coin, because insurance company need not take care of his health because he's exercising. So this H is the coin, and there is a wearable which is given to the patient, and if he exercises regularly, the wearable will tell to the chain that yes, he is exercising daily, and that goes to the ledger, the coin gets released to the patient. So this is ensuring that the patient is exercising every day. And the insurance company is giving you that coin. And that coin, you can't use that coin anywhere else, but you can use that coin to buy insurance for your child or for yourself next year's premium. So what is insurance company doing? Insurance company is protecting itself by exercising you, so you don't have to visit the hospitals that frequently. And the IoT device, it could be a watch belt or whatever, cap. The IoT device is telling back the insurance company, yes, this fellow is going to walk every day and walking whatever 10 minutes every day. And if that meets the goal, the coin is released, he is gratified, he is given the benefit of doing good exercise, and he can use that coin back to buy insurance. These are the companies which are doing different kinds of, they're all blockchain based companies. Who are doing solving different kinds of problems. That time is for solving the patient records. This is a coin transaction.
It's a government issue.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, everything. I have 30 slides. So, coming to real estate. Real estate is again lot of bureaucracy. Bureaucracy, if you go and find out what it is. It is a slow government process. That is what Wikipedia says. Involved slow government process, lack of transparency, real and records getting mistakes in the public records getting tampered. Anything which has to be tampered and which has to be made tamper proof, blockchain. These are the Atlanta.io is one such thing which brings sellers and buyers together, and OBPT and all that stuff. Mainly crowdfunding is again one big place where someone wants money and someone wants to give money, and to prove that he has done what he has promised. He has promised to build something, and he has taken money from these people. Has he really kept up his promise? IT programs, voting, yes, he is right, he is right. So these are the open ledger based platform or the platforms which are removing the middleman, removing the high fees, and removing the centralized body. Like if you take Kickstarter, for instance, is a centralized body. It's a one single organization where you can go for crowdfunding, but it is up to Kickstarter to ask for whatever percentage upfront, and also it is left to Kickstarter to promote someone. When you open his page, some project comes up. It is left to him. Whoever pays more gets his page come up onto the Kickstarter's website. So he can promote more or more. So But if you go to a set, if you go to a blockchain based thing, you will not have that side taking business. Energy, as I told you an example, and, there is a huge thing at the government level, at an international level, to trade carbon footprints and carbon and emissions, and also to trade just raw power. This is one such example, and LO3 energy is one. So this is a process as to what is the traditional way of doing energy distribution as opposed to a blockchain based energy distribution. Of course, a complete supply chain. Charity is similar to crowdfunding to an extent, but few problems with charity is inefficiency. You collect money but not do it. Corruption in charity, very big, we all know. Proof that our money is reaching the end user, again a big thing in charity. I give some money, I'm not sure whether it has reached the ask my limited financial services, transaction fees is associated, lack of transparency and long times. How these people have solved charity using Bitcoin is this. There is a charity company which sets some goals. It will say that I will take care of 100 cancer patients. Then you donate the second thing. Then the charity company goes and does the work. And the public, the chain owners validate it. Yes, 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 he has done it. Then your payment gets released. This is how is the one way how one of these companies, Alice.si, has dealt with charity using a blockchain platform. Cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is such a big topic. I can have 4 days, 8 hours session completely on this, and can still go on and on and on. Thanks to Manju, actually, he was instrumental to sending me to Israel to get one of this cybersecurity stuffs about 4 years ago. Some of these are the problems in cybersecurity, and there are about at least 200 companies using blockchain, 200 companies using blockchain, dealing with cybersecurity at different levels, either eliminating humans, either the form factor of the whole stuff, just dealing with authentication and storage, if you want to store complex data, government data, and not accessible to anyone. And to have traceability or not have traceability. And most of them, not most, but the majority chunk of them are funded companies from Israel. Some of them. And DOS, who knows what DOS is? So DOS to a layman is attacking a system continuously. Yes, attacking a system continuously, anonymously. There are many blockchain companies, example is GRDS, which is primarily focused and they have an expertise to stop DOS and stop distributed DOS, as well. WD stands for distributed DOS. Denial of services DOS. Supply chain management. Supply chain management, though I've put it number 9, has huge applications across the board, starting from shipping companies to grocery stores. You can see this IBM grocery store example coming up in YouTube every other day. You browse for blockchain, and next advertisement which gets put onto your YouTube is this IBM's Hyperchain example, talking about tracing your food as it moves from different hands, from the farmer to the to your shopping cart inside a grocery store. It has to move different hands. It has to move through a shipping company, a packing company. You negotiate price. You release your prices in different stages as your goods move through it, and the whole process of watching, yes, it has reached there, yes, it has reached there, yes, it has met this goal, yes, it has done this, it has fulfilled this contract, and in doing so, you reduce cost, reduce labor, wastage of time. So without this, if a carrot which was grown in some part of Kashmir, or apple which was grown in some part of Kashmir, if it has to reach Bangalore, with all kinds of things would take 15 days. If you had this process and intermediate release of funds, it would take 10 days or even 5 days. And these are some of them. There are hybrid inter-exchange opportunities because there are shipping companies, logistic companies involved. So if one blockchain has to talk to another blockchain, you have to have interoperability, exchange chain and block verifier, one such platform. They are not a product, they are a platform. And you can use that platform to build a supply chain management application, POC, or whatever, especially for entrepreneurs who want to do something in blockchain and who want to do something in supply chain related blockchain applications. Uber times have gone. Because why they have gone? Because Uber dictates the price. Uber dictates when it wants to search. Uber dictates when it wants to set the price during peak times. And the driver doesn't have any say, nor the customer who is riding doesn't have any say. But with blockchain, you lose the central guy. The driver can demand whatever price he wants. And the customer can say, yes, I agree. And also other share of ride. If you want to know who is your co-passenger, and if you want to know, like, know your customer, know your passenger, kind of stuff. Blockchains can help you do it. This is the list of companies which are just doing financial services. Just financial services. And a very small list. Very, very small list. In all these places, exchanges, brokerage, soft wallets, hard wallets, investments, money services, smart contracts, platforms, APIs, payments, payrolls, ATMs, trading. These are the list of startup companies which are in different. That was only banking and finance, and this is in all other places. All other places could be just enterprise services and currencies, it could be brokerages, it could be browsers, it could be capital markets, it could be storage, security, energy, IoT, mainly IoT. IoT is a good example which I told you was the healthcare thing, but the wristwatch tells you this fellow really walked for 10 miles today. You have to give him a coin. This one such IoT company. And of course, many of the merchant services.